Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa barik wa sallim wa salli alayhi. Aqul Rabbi zidni ilma. Always say that, O Allah, increase me in knowledge. And our Shaykh, Sayyidina Shaykh Muhammad Ramadan, Shaykh Sayyid Abdul al-Jilani, رضي الله تعالى عنه says, درست العلم حتى صرت قطبا ونلت السعادة من مولى الموالي. I learned knowledge until I reached to the highest spiritual stage, and that is the stage of qutb. There is nobody higher than qutb. And he says, I achieved that stage and that status by seeking knowledge, learning knowledge. 25 years, he says, I spent in the desert of Iraq. And sometimes I used to feel unconscious, and I used to eat only grass and drink water and eat leaves for 25 years. And sometimes I was not able to bear the hardship, and I used to feel unconscious, and the people used to come and they put me on the bed, take me to hospital, and they thought that I am dead. They prepare my funeral, gave ghusl to me, bath to me, and put me on the funeral bed, and then they used to see the movement in me, and I used to get up. He says, I did that 25 years just to seek the knowledge, to learn the knowledge. He is Sayyidina Abu Salih Abdul Qadir bin Musa bin Abdullah bin Yahya bin Muhammad bin Dawud bin Musa bin Abdullah bin Hassan al-Musanna bin Sayyidina Imam al-Hassan bin Ali ibn Abi Talib. So between him and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there are 11 people or 11 generations. His father was Musa Jangidos. He was a warrior. He was the actual the striver, the mujahid, who used to spend all of his life, and who spent all of his life just doing jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And jihad does not mean taking the sword and killing the enemies of Islam and killing those people of non-believers. No. Jihad means who spent all of his life to attain the pleasure of Allah. And he was in Gilan, present-day Iran. And you know that famous story, how he married to his wife, Amatul Khayr Fatima, the mother of Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani, our Shaykh, Sayyidina Ghawth Azam, Shaykh Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani. He was in near the garden, and he was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the flowing stream. There was a river, and he used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the mountainous area. And the Gilan is a very mountainous area. It's very scenic, it's full of mountains. Very high land, we can call it. And that is part of Iran. And he used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there. And one day, he was very hungry, and he saw in the river that there is one apple. Apple is floating in the river, and he was hungry. So he thought, oh, this is apple. Allah has sent it for me. So he ate it. Then he regretted. He thought, oh, what I have done. I did not get the permission of the owner of this apple. I should have got the permission of this owner of the apple. Then he walked from the source of the water towards the source of the water. And he reached to a garden, and in that garden he found that the apple tree are just leaning on the water. And he thought, this is the place from where possibly the apple would have fallen into the water. He went to the owner of that garden, of the apple trees, and he asked him, you know, I have made a mistake. And the mistake is that I have eaten an apple from your garden without your permission. Can you forgive it to me before I die and I have to be accountable on the day of judgment? So please forgive it to me. That Shaykh, he was Shaykh, he was from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, among the descendants of Sayyidina Rasulullah and descendants of Sayyidina Imam Hussain alayhi wa sallam. You know, grandfather of Sayyidina Imam Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala, our Shaykh radiallahu ta'ala. He noticed that this person is not ordinary. There is something special with him, because otherwise the young man, you know, who bothers, who cares? He is taking special care of his akhirah, his life hereafter. There is something special with him. He says, I'm not going to marry you. I'm not going to forgive you. I'll not forgive you until there are two conditions you have to meet. Number one, you have to serve me for 2 years or so. And in those 2 years, you have to be my slave and to give me service. You will be provided with food and accommodation, with your needs, but no salary, nothing. I will see you, what is your worth, what is your value. And then there is another condition which I will tell you later, after you will complete these 2 years. He says, fine. He stayed with him for 2 years. Could you imagine? You are living and we are living in a society, in home, with our family, and we have our responsibilities, and then we made mistake. And for just to rectify that mistake, we have been asked just to spend 2 years to serve somebody. Can we do that? Very difficult. Impossible in our time. Impossible. I said, fine, okay. 2 years, he watched him. Abdullah Somati, the person, owner of that garden, Abdullah Somati, his name was Abdullah, and this was Musa. So he watched him very closely, how he is in his prayers, how he behaves, how he acts and reacts to the situations, how he is in worships, in his prayers, does he get up for tahajjud prayer or not, all those activities, he watched him very closely. And he found him very strong, spiritual person. 2 years were completed. He said, Sisi, can you forgive me the apple which I have eaten? And can you tell me the second condition? He said, yes, there is condition. And you know that story. The condition was, he said, you have to marry my daughter. And the daughter is deaf. She can't hear. She does not hear. She can't speak. She is blind. And she is disabled, crippled. Disabled. If you are ready to marry her, then I'm ready to forgive that apple for you. Otherwise, there is no way. He says, I don't want any burden in my life after this life, hereafter, after the grave. So whatever burden I have to bear in this life. And I don't want to take any burden, even the burden of an apple, for life. So I am ready to marry. So they were married. So when he went to his wife, she was perfectly okay. She was a young, beautiful lady. And he entered into the room, and as he found that this is not that description which the Shaykh and Sayyidina Abdullah Somai gave to me. This description is completely different, opposite of that. But he told me she's not blind, she's not deaf, she is not the person who is able to speak, she is not disabled. So this is not the description which he has given. So he ran out of the house. He says, I thought that I have come to the wrong room and there is a wrong person. As he came out, he found Abdullah Swami at the door. He said to him, "Don't run away, my son. That is your wife." I said, "She is blind, not because she is physically blind. I said it blind because she never saw anything unlawful with her eyes throughout her life. She is deaf because she never heard anything unlawful through his ears, her ears. She is disabled because she never stepped out of her house against the law of Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet throughout her life. And she is disabled in her hands because she never did anything against Allah and his Prophet." And that was the mother of our beloved Shaykh Sayyid Abdul Qadir, Shaykh Sayyid Abdul Qadir. Her name was Amatul Khair Fatim. Amatul Khair Fatim. She was a blessed lady. And she was great. She says herself, she says, Lamma Wulitu Ibni Abdul Qadir, when I gave birth to my son, Abdul Qadir, he never took his milk during the days of month of Ramadan. He never took the milk. He used to keep fast, even in his childhood, when he was a very young child, in the first year of his life. He was born on 11th of Rabiul Thani. So Rabiul Thani, Jamadiul Awwal, Jamadiul Thani, Rajab, Shaban, about 4 months old. He was 4 months old, or 5 months, or 5 months old, when he observed fasting. And she says, when he observed fasting, what he used to do, he never took milk during the daylight. And one year, when there was confusion about the moon, whether the month of Ramadan has ended or not, the people came to me. They asked me, "Since morning, since dawn, did Abdul Qadir take milk or not?" I told them, I informed them, no, he did not take milk. So they fasted. They kept fasting as well. Later on, they knew that day was month of Ramadan. And then it became famous all over the country, or all over the city in Milan, or that there is a child in Ashraf, in the Sadat, in the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the descendants of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is a child. He fasts, he observes fasting during the month of Ramadan in his childhood. Infanthood, he does that. He was born, radiyallahu anhu, in 470 Hijrah. 470 Hijrah. Now we are in 1432 Hijrah. So we are talking about 1,000 years ago, or 970 years ago, when he was born, radiyallahu ta'ala. And he was passed away in 561 Hijrah at the age of 91 years in Baghdad. He is buried in Baghdad, and he, radiyallahu ta'ala, says, "Whoever will pass by my madrasa, whoever will go in front of my door of my madrasa, my university, my college, my institute, if he is subject to punishment, Allah will reduce his punishment on the day of judgment. And if somebody goes in front of my madrasa, pass by my madrasa, and he is someone who is my believer and who has seen me." There was one person, he died, and he used to cry at night in his grave. And so much screaming that the people used to hear his screaming. And they were terrified, and they were frightened because of the screams of that person who died in his time. And they complained, the people came and they complained to Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani, and they said, "Sheikh, there is a problem. At night, we are not able to sleep and we are very frightened since so and so man has died. Or somebody has died, we can hear something from his grave, screams from his grave. So you need to make dua for him or do something.